Hi, welcome to CPT Mathematics.
Hi, hope you guys are good. So today we're going to be talking about logarithms. So first of all, let's explain what is logarithms about. So logarithms has been discovered many years ago, around about 1600, by the first scientist called Jos Bergi, who actually put some calculations. So that time it was called red numbers, and after John Napier came with more light, so that's where we actually named our red numbers logarithms. So let's discuss about logarithms. So logarithms, actually the simple logarithm, if I write log of base b, a equal to x. So the simple of logarithms is actually to express the power to which b is the raised to x to give a. So that's actually the simple logarithms is to express the power to which b will be the rest of that power to give a. So if you take an example, let's say logarithm of base 2 of 16, we know it's going to give you 4. So why am I saying that? So that symbol is actually giving the power in which that the power in which the base 2 is the rest of 4 to give 16. So that's actually the definition of logarithm. So then don't get confused. So if you take another example, I could have taken like log base 3 of 9. It's going to give us 2 because the power, the base is actually the base is actually raised to 2 to give 9. So the symbol of log is actually to give the power to which the base is raised to 2 to give 9. So that's actually the definition of log. So if now we talk about log and exponential form. So let's discuss about log and exponential form. So in this case, so when we're talking about log form, so if we have log base 2 to 16, we know it's going to give us 4, right? So that's actually called log form. So exponential form is actually to express the power to which the base is raised to give 16. So that's called exponential form. So regarding now, we're going to be talking about the laws of log. So the law of log, there are actually certain formulas that need to be understood for you to resolve some log problem. So let's see the first one. So the first one, if you have log to the base b of a multiplied by d, so the first log is going to give you log of that same base of a plus that log, the base must already be the same, yeah? And secondly, if you have log of base a of e, of a over d. So it's going to give you log that base b of a minus log of base b of d. So that's the second one. If you have log of base b of a to the power n. So in this case, the power comes here, and then you have log of that base a. So the fourth one, if you have log of base b and b, in this case we're going to give you 1. But later on I will actually demonstrate everything for you to understand clearly what I'm talking about. But I'm just giving you the laws of log, so but we're going to be doing more exercises for you to understand how to make 1. If you have log base b of 1, here is going to give you 0. So don't forget those laws. But later on, as I said, I will explain more on exercises for you to understand. So on the sixth one, if you have a to the power log of base a of b, in this case, it must be b. Why am I saying that? I'm saying that because, look, a long time ago, those scientists, they actually discovered those formula. They actually demonstrate it, but in some of them they don't really actually demonstrate it. But when you notice, like when you have A to the power log, if the base is the same, if the base is the same, that because that one is actually a number that is actually raised to the power log of A, base A and B. So if the base is the same, that one, so it's gonna give you B. So that's what you must know. So let's say for instance, let's take another example. So here, if you have 2 log base 2 of 3x, here you must give you 3x. Must give you 3x because the base 2 is actually the same, not 2. So that's the power of 2. But in that log, the base 2 is actually the same here. So that's what I'm giving you 3x. So that's the formula that you must know because we generally use it mostly in some logs problems. So here, let's talk about the chain of the base. The chain of the base of log. So here in this case, if you have log of A, right? So in this case, we're talking about chain of base. So this one, this expression of log, we know it's going to be log of A over log of B, right? In this case, here you can notice that we don't have the base, but we know that the common log, when we have like log of only A, we know that it's going to give you log the base 10. That you must always know it. So when the base is not given, the base will not always be 10. So that's what we call actually the common log. It's because when the base is not given, the base is always 10. So in this case, we know that this expression equals this one. So we can actually write that log base B of A is log base 10 A log is 10 B. So the base is the same, right? So the base is the same. If the base is the same on the numerator, the base is the same on the denominator. So here, actually, we can actually change the base by any number. So we could have written like, put like the base, let's put like 20. Won't change anything, it will always give you the same answer. So you must know that when the base is not given, the base of the expression of log is always 10. So the change of base is if you have the base in the denominator, you have the same base in the numerator, sorry, the same base in the denominator. So you can always put the same base here, the same base here, it won't change the result of log problems. So that's what you must know regarding the change of the base of the log. And also I wanted to add something. What I wanted to add is that's good. So in this case, if I log of let's say 2, 6, right? It's gonna give you log of 16 over log of 2, right? So this one is also log base 10. It's because the base is not given. If the base is not given, so it's gonna be 10, right? So this one is equal also to that. So as I was explaining, so this is actually the example that I showed you, the change of the base. So when the base is not given, because this expression is giving us this one, so the base can actually 10. So knowing also the base here is the same both sides, so we could also write put any base that we wanted. We could actually put any base that we wanted, like x 16 log base x 2. So this one is the same, so we can always give you the same answer. So now we understand the change of the base. So it's actually a manipulation like of change of the base. So that's actually so let's take a small break. So the important one is that I wanted to talk about that you guys just must know if you change or replace. That's the important notice that I want to actually talk about. So here, if you have example log of base 2 of 16, so we know that one is going to give us that one. Right. So here, I just want to show you some configuration. So here, I can actually write like that, 1 over log. But in this case, because the base here was 2, so here of the base would be 16. Right? So, the important note that I wanted to share with you guys, just to show you that I can always change the base by putting 1 over that expression by actually exchanging numbers, like what was what was the base gonna be actually won't be the base, so 16 gonna be the base because now I'm putting 1 over. So that's actually my manipulation or change of the base, because you guys can face some exercise. Let's say for instance, if I let's take an example. If I have that 1 over log base none of 3, right? So here it's gonna give you log, so the base will change. So here it's gonna give you 2. So you can actually see by yourself. So that's actually an important notice that I wanted to share. So don't get confused. So when you have this expression, because it's 1 over log of base none of 3, you can actually change the base. So the base now won't be the base, so 3 will not be the base, and you write it like this, it will give you 2. So same thing here. So you guys, hope you guys understand what I'm trying to explain. So let's go further.
So I have also an important notice that I wanted to share with you guys. So if you have that log of base, let's say b of d equal here, log the same base here of C. In this case, as you can notice, we have log B, base B of D, equal to log base B of C, right? In this case, this expression here is the same as this expression here. Is the same. So I can actually, by equalizing, it's going to give you D equals C. So don't get confused. So you're going to be finding some errors like that. So let's take a small example. So if I have a log of base 2 of 3x, right, equal log base 2 of 3x plus 1, right? So this expression here is the same as this expression here. I can take it off. So it's going to be equal to 3x equal to 3x plus 1. So I just want to show you this. So here we then go put 3x squared plus 1, because if I put 3x equal to 3x plus 1, it won't really make sense. So let's put it like that. So this expression is the same as this expression, so I can actually equalize this expression to that, right? So here we're going to be having 3x squared minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0. And then you can solve by using the quadratic formula, the log minus b plus b squared minus 4c over 2a. So that's already. So I just want to show you, that important notice. So when you have like log this base b, and if you notice that the same base that you have here, so you equalize those two expressions. So same thing here, is the same, you have this expression equal. You equalize these two expressions. So yeah, just wanted to share with you guys that important notice. Well, let's go further on natural natural log. So natural log is that expression that you guys are familiar with, is ln x, right? So we always write ln depending on x code. We cannot just write ln itself like that. It doesn't make
makes sense. It doesn't exist. So we need to always work with x. So we depends on x. So that's a known natural law. So this natural law, we need x here. So let me explain you a small story. So back those days, so a little x natural log has been put just to actually simplify some calculation of exponential function. Because if we have an example, for instance, like lim of e to the power x, we know it's not given x, right? But back in the days, it wouldn't be nice for you to write log to the power log of e to the power x. You see? So back in those days, those scientists, they have actually introduced the natural log to make it actually nicer to be written. Because for them, back in those days, when they were writing this, it wasn't proper for them to be written. So that's why actually they actually introduced natural law. So that's actually small important thing that you guys should know. So if I have example, right? If I have example like log base e of x, right? And we know it's going to give you log of x over log of e. So here log and e are twins, they are the same. So this expression also gives you that. Right? And we know that ln of e is going to give you 1. So it's going to give you ln of x over 1. So that's what it's going to give you, ln of x. So let's take a small example for you to see what I'm talking is right by saying that ln and log, they are actually twins. You're going to always find the same answer if you use both of them. So let's take, if you have that log of 2 base 2 of 16, right? So let me write it down. If you have log of base 2 of 16, we know it's going to give you log of 16 over log of 2, right? So we know that we know it's going to give you 4. So we could also write that ln of 16 over ln of 2. So let's crunch it in your calculator, you're going to see the answer, and you're going to actually compare. So for you guys, as you guys have crunch in your calculator, you can notice it's going to give you the same answer. So I was saying, so ln and log, they are trees. So back in those days, for them writing the expression of log in terms of exponential wasn't nicer to be written for them. So you know those sentences there, they are actually somewhere fancy. So yeah, so now you know what I was actually explaining, what I was talking about. So ln and log, they are the same that print. So you can use it like by solving like any kind of log problems. So your choice will be yours. Either you choose ln or either you choose log. So let's do it. So now you know. So let's go further on another topic.
When it happened was around 1600. That was the era of William Shakespeare in England, Galileo in Italy, and in Switzerland, a watchmaker named Jost Burgi. He was actually more than a watchmaker. He was the instrument maker for the Royal Observatory there. He also helped with some of their mathematical calculations, and that often meant multiplying numbers with lots of digits. Turns out that Jost wasn't the only guy thinking about these ideas around 1600. A Scottish nobleman named John Napier had pretty much the same idea. He didn't just call them the red numbers, he called them logarithms.